How to get started in boudoir photography. So you've probably noticed that boudoir has exploded in our industry in the last few years. And if you're like most people, you have no idea where to get started. But in this video, I'm gonna give you the four things you need to know to start shooting boudoir as quickly and as easily as possible.
It's showtime.
Hello, my name is Mike Lloyd, and I run a multi-six-figure boudoir studio here in Silicon Valley, California. I freaking love shooting boudoir. I get to make people feel great about themselves, and I make a solid living doing it. That's a win for everybody. I've learned a lot over the years. I've been shooting professionally for 12 years and doing boudoir full-time for 7 of those, and was really overwhelming in the beginning, but I've learned how to distill everything that I know into very quick, easy, actionable steps because I've been teaching photography for almost a decade as well.
You think I'm qualified?
So I'm going to give you the four things you need to get started shooting quickly and easily. Number one, defining what boudoir means to you and why you want to shoot it. Number two, how to price yourself. Number three, what equipment do you need? And number four, how to start getting clients in the door. Starting with number one, because usually that's where you start, defining boudoir and why you want to shoot it. If you just want to do this to make money, you're probably going to burn out because being a professional photographer is a shitload of work, not going to lie. And about 95% of what you do in the beginning has nothing to do with actually holding a camera. You do 95% of your time on the business and 5% of your time shooting. Then as you grow the business, you start reinvesting the money you make into hiring contractors to do your marketing, your social media management, your email marketing, everything else you're doing, your editing, your sales, your consultations. Then you can focus on doing the shooting if that's the part you love the most. But in the beginning, you have to be willing to do everything else. So if the only reason you want to do this is to make money, I suggest learning to scale those operations as quickly as possible so you're not the one doing the things you really don't want to do. Also, define what boudoir means to you because it means something different to everybody. Some people want to take sexy photos. Some people want to empower their clients. Some people want to just shoot creatively and this is a good outlet for them. Whatever your reason is, great. And whatever boudoir looks like to you, awesome. Just be clear about it because you will attract a certain type of client and you will repel other types of clients. And that is good. You don't want to attract everybody. Not everyone will be your client. But when you know the types of people that you want to work with, your messaging will speak to them. They will come seek you out and you'll grow your business so much faster. But if you just say, well, everyone is my client because I'll photograph anybody, you're not going to photograph anybody. It's like shouting to a crowd of people on top of a milk crate, trying to convince people to believe what you're saying. Everyone's like, who's that crazy person shouting to all of us? No one's actually going to stop and listen. But if you're like, hey, newly single moms out there who are struggling to create a new identity after your relationship is over and you want to be more than your career and your role as a parent, I got a thing for you. Every single person who fits that profile is going to be like, oh, yeah, I'm listening. You've clearly catered this message to me. You've got my attention. What's up? That's how all this works. So defining what you want to shoot, who you want to shoot, and why is going to help you scale everything so much more quickly because people will know who you are and what you're all about from the beginning. All right, number two, how to price yourself. Most photographers get into the game because we love photography, and almost every single person on the planet has debilitating money blocks. If you are not willing to charge professional prices, you are going to attract the types of clients who just want a bargain. They don't care who's behind the camera. They just want someone to snap a few pics and give them a CD full of images, even though computers don't even really have CD-ROMs anymore. But that's just it. When you define yourself as an artist who performs a valuable service and you charge accordingly, you will attract the kind of clients who love what you do. So pricing is not just so you can make money, it's also a marketing and branding move. But yes, we need to make money. You have to consider all of your costs. It costs money to print things. My albums generally run between $120 and $250. That costs me money to print, plus hair and makeup, my social media management. I pay an editor to edit my stuff. I have this shoot space. There are a lot of costs that go into it. Your clients don't care about that, and you shouldn't use that as part of your, you know, persuasive marketing. It's like, well, sorry I have to charge so much, but it costs a lot to run a business. They don't care. You charge a lot because you deliver a valuable service and you're worth it. And then your pricing reflects your ability to make profit and pay your business expenses. Now, if you don't want to hire an editor and a social media manager and any of these other things in the beginning to keep your costs down, great. I totally support that. You're going to pay for these things in time, and your time is worth something. So charge accordingly, because you're giving up time from your friends, your family, your hobbies, from sleep. I can't just nap all the time every day and travel the world because I run a business. I'm getting to the point of growing the business to run without me. But again, I still love photography. I'm not going to give that up, but I can have the business running beyond the hours that I contribute to it. That is where I'm excited to get to. If you don't want to get to that point, that's great too. But again, your price dictates how much time you get to spend doing the things that you enjoy in life, and it attracts the kind of clients who will really appreciate what you do. So I have other videos on how to price your work. I have a deep dive course in the Boudoir Guild on how to price yourself. So if you want like really step-by-step thorough instructions on how to do that, dive over, then head over to boudoirguild.com. And you can sign up there. All right, the next thing, equipment. Every photographer loves to chat about equipment until you get to a certain point when you realize that it doesn't really matter. In the beginning, we call it GAS, gear acquisition syndrome, and every photographer has it at some point. You're like, oh, if I just had this one more lens or this one more light modifier, this one more thing, I could be anything I want, which all the equipment we use is a tool for a job. So if you don't need to do the job, you don't need the tool for the job. I think laser cutters are super neat. I can make all kinds of really cool things out of sheet metal, but I have no use for all these fancy shapes out of sheet metal. So for me to buy a laser cutter really doesn't do me any good. I could just go rent the stuff or hire someone on Etsy to cut it for me if I need to, which brings up the next point in the equipment acquisition strategy session of this video. If you're not sure whether or not you need a piece of equipment, any camera store mostly will rent gear, or you can rent them online at borrowlenses.com. There's a handful of other sites. You can go on, try out a new camera body, try out new lenses. That's what I did before I bought my 70-200. Ta-da! This little guy, $2,500. This wasn't like a, oh yeah, I'll just throw down a couple bucks for this new piece of gear. No, I rented one like four times to see how much I actually use it during a shoot. And then, do my clients even buy the images that I took with this lens? You're like, well, why would that be any different? Well, this is a zoom lens in a studio. So this is for more detailed close-up shots, whereas 98% of everything I shoot is with my 50, my prime. I love this lens. It's my favorite. It's like all I use otherwise. I was making really good money, taking great photos with my 50, so do I even need to do this thing, or would it have been a neat thing to have if I had it? And a lot of clients were buying the close-up detailed stuff I took with this one. Could I get close-up details with my 50? Technically, yes. But I'm also not gonna put the camera like right up against my client's body to take photos. That's kind of uncomfortable. But with this one, I can shoot from across the room and get those detail shots without invading my client's personal bubble. So yes, I could get more things. My clients were buying them, and I spent, I don't know, $100 over a few days of renting this and testing it out during shoots. And then the camera store applied that rental fee toward the purchase of the lens. And now I use it all the time. I love this thing. It helps me make more money. But I found that out because I spent a little bit of money to rent it to see if I even needed it. So if you're curious about what gear you need a camera that is reliable. You need a lens. I love my 50 millimeter. Zoom lenses are neat too. But again, rent them for next to nothing. See what works for you in the space that you have. As far as lighting goes, I used one light for all of my shoots for like 8 years. And developed my style with that. If you don't want to shoot dark and moody, you can do the same thing with one light still, or natural light. But when you learn how to use light, you can make do with just about anything. Again, rent lights, figure out how to use them, figure out what you need, and then buy what works for you. Then you get to editing. You need a powerful enough computer. I don't know of anywhere you can rent computers like that. Maybe at a library, business center of a hotel, but they probably don't want you to install software. And then you need some editing software. I use Adobe Photoshop and Lightroom. You can sign up for their photographer's package, which is a $10 a month subscription. Also, I hire an editor to do most of my retouching for me because I don't want to spend the time doing all that editing work when I could be doing other things like taking a day off once a week. You know, you'll figure that out on your own, but you need very basic software to do editing until you get to the point of outsourcing all of your work. All right. And then number four, how to get clients in the door. When most people get started, they make some Facebook posts, Instagram posts, you know, here's my new photography business, running a flash sale, model call, whatever. And you might book a couple of people, make a few $100, and then you do it again and it's crickets. And you're like, okay, you've exhausted your immediate circle of friends or folks that, you know, were kind of on the periphery. Now you need to get people into your world who were not otherwise in your world. And that is a three-step process. Figure out who you're marketing to, where are they, and what can you offer to them. Let's just use Instagram brides-to-be, for example. So if I want to do bridal boudoir shoots, where are brides hanging out? Well, they're on Instagram. They might be on TikTok. Depending on their age, they could be on Facebook. They could be at bridal fairs. There are a lot of places where I can find these brides. Let's talk about Instagram. Okay, so I'm going to go on Instagram. I'm going to show images related to bridal boudoir and use appropriate hashtags based on your area and bridal themed tags. And then you're gonna go follow other companies who cater to your same audience. And you're gonna search local hashtags, find out who's getting engaged, and just comment on their posts. Like, oh, congratulations, that's so exciting. You picked a beautiful venue. What a great time of year to get married. You're just making yourself known. You're not giving sales pitches. You're not slipping into their DMs. You are just making yourself known. And then they're like, oh, thank you for the congratulations. Who are you? And they check out your page. Like, oh, I've been looking for a photographer. What a coincidence. Totally not a coincidence, right? But that's how we do it on Instagram. Or you can run ads. There's a ton of ways you can do it. But that's exactly it. You figure out who you're marketing to, where they are, and then what is your offer? Maybe with your bridal session, you're like, cool. And then there's this free extra nightstand gift if this is a gift on your wedding day, or, you know, do a free engagement session, something like that. If their wedding photographer hasn't already done it, you could offer, you know, $100 off, or include a free spray tan or waxing or massage day or some sort of thing that's relevant to their wedding or the wedding prep process included in your shoot. And eventually you'll get to the point where you don't have to even offer anything. Your service alone is valuable enough, which it already was in the first place, but psychology, we are attracting people into our world. So that is one example of how to do it. If you want to know more about marketing your brand, I've got another video, my five favorite ways to attract clients in 2022, and a ton of other marketing videos on this channel. So be sure to dive deep into those, as well as I cover pricing and branding and how to choose the right equipment. Everything is here on this channel, or you could head over to boudoirguild.com and join the membership over there, where I really dive deep and walk you step by step, basically holding your hand and walking you through how to do all this stuff on your own. So there you go. Now you know the four things you need to get started to shoot boudoir as quickly and easily as possible. What are you shooting? Who are you shooting? What equipment do you need? How do you price yourself? And how do you get people in the door? So enjoy this journey. It's a fun one. It's a lucrative one. And I'm stoked that you're a part of it. You're amazing. I'll see you inside.